So a lot of you are participating in Camp NaNoWriMo, the month of July where you dedicate a certain amount toward your writing goal to get it done. However, statistically speaking, near the middle of the month is when people start to stop writing. They give up. The excitement wears off. Well, I'm here to encourage you. Keep at it. You're doing great. And today specifically, I want to give you 6 tips to help you write faster so you can keep that momentum and power through. Let's get started. Hello everyone, welcome back. My name is David Webb and I made this channel to give you the best tips on writing and creativity so you can finally finish your book or have that creative career you've always dreamed of. Let's clear up 3 things right off the bat. First of all, a lot of people are passionate about the way you pronounce NaNoWriMo, and I'm here to tell you we're all doing it wrong. There is no right way to say it without sounding like an idiot. None of us are saying it correctly. Think about it. The people who advocate for NaNoWriMo are saying that you say ry because the word writing begins with the sound ry. But if you use that logic, we would be saying the word NaNoWriMo. And that just sounds ridiculous. So I personally don't care if you say NaNoWriMo or NaNoWriMo. I personally prefer NaNoWriMo. My point is, don't get salty if people don't pronounce it the way you like it, because you're pronouncing it wrong too. Second, I know the title of this video is grammatically incorrect, but as it turns out, people search in Google and YouTube for how to write fast. Not how to write quickly, how to write fast. So I'm just trying to speak your language here, guys. Finally, there are a lot of benefits to writing quickly. Yes, the faster you write, the sloppier, the messier it'll be. However, we have editors for that sort of thing. There are people out there who would shame you for writing quickly. Don't listen to them. The same people that would shame you for doing so aren't writing anything. Simply by committing to writing the amount that you are, that speaks volumes, so don't let anyone discourage you. With those 3 things out of the way, let's get into it. Number 1, write every day. For those of you who have been on this channel any length of time, you know how much I'm an advocate for writing every single day. However, in the context of writing more quickly, this is going to help you to get back into your writing every single day. It's gonna mean when you sit down to write fresh words the next day, it's gonna be so much easier to just pick up where you left off and keep going without losing much momentum. You're training your brain every single day that when you sit down to write, you mean business. Number 2, ask yourself the magic 5 before you write every single scene. The magic 5 being who, what, when, where, why. Ideally, yes, you will have plotted out your entire novel before you get started. For most writers, no matter how much they protest otherwise, a clear outline will help them to write their entire book faster. But even if you write by the seat of your pants, you can do this. Before you write every single scene, answer those 5 questions. Who's gonna be in the scene? What's going to happen in the scene? When does it take place? Where does it take place? And why is the scene taking place? Namely, the main conflict that drives the scene forward. If you start every single scene with a very specific goal in mind, it's gonna make writing that chapter so much easier. This was the one thing that really unlocked writing quickly for me. It's what empowered me to write the second book of my series, which arguably was the hardest for me to write. Number 3, set specific goals. If you just sit down every single day and say, I want to write today, you might get some writing done, but you're not aiming toward anything specific. And I know a lot of you have already set specific goals, but a lot of you have set goals for the entire month. You want to write this much in a month. Some of you, your goal today is to make up for what you didn't do yesterday. But I'm telling you, if you sit down with a very specific number of words that you want to write, it's gonna be a whole lot easier for you to do so. It's weird psychology. Trust me on this. The only caveat is you can't go into it with a mindset of, oh my gosh, I have to write 1,000 words. You gotta go into it saying, okay, I'm gonna write 1,000 words right now. If this is your first time joining me on this channel, thank you so much for taking the time to watch. It would mean the world to me if you hit the little subscribe button down there. I give writing tips almost every single week, so if you stick around and if you keep watching, you won't regret it. So hit subscribe and then hit the little bell to be notified of all future uploads. Number 4, perform writing sprints. It's a little bit trickier to just sit down and knock out 1,000 words just like that than if you were to go into it and write 250 words and then stop. Take a very short break, not long enough to get yourself distracted, but just long enough to take a deep breath, re-energize your mind, get pumped up again, and then knock out another 250 words. Or you can make it time-based to spread it out more evenly. I like to use the Pomodoro technique, which is write for 15 minutes, take a break for 5 minutes, write another 15 minutes, take a break for 5 minutes, and then just keep repeating that process. And I can't tell you how much it helps when you're trying to knock out a large goal when you break it up into smaller chunks and take regular breaks. Number 5, play word wars. I used to do this all the time when I couldn't conjure up the motivation to write quickly myself. So I would find other author friends on Facebook and challenge them to a word war. Whoever would write the most amount of words in 1 hour would win bragging rights for the next week. For those of you willing to take the chance, say the loser has to buy dinner. This tactic works especially well if you have a competitive nature. And honestly, it just feels so good to beat out a bunch of writers and say that you got the most words done. And then finally, number 6, use speech to text. I'd say the vast majority of writers do their writing at a keyboard. A small percentage use pen and paper, but an even smaller percentage dictate their words. Dictation is an incredibly powerful tool. It engages a different part of your mind, making it easier to write dialogue, for example, but also you speak a little bit more freely than if you were writing. You also generally speak faster than you type. And finally, if you're dictating your words, especially if you're not looking at the screen, it's a whole lot easier to shut off your inner editor. Which, by the way, is my bonus tip. Shut off your inner editor. If you sit back and obsess about what you're writing while you're writing it, you are going to slow yourself down. But as far as dictation goes, there are a growing number of apps that support this function. I'm pretty sure Microsoft Word, Google Docs, everything has its own little dictation feature now, allowing you to sit back and just talk out your words. And before you know it, you'll hit your writing goal. I've dictated a 3,000 word chapter before, thinking that I got out maybe 1,000 at best. Trust me on this one, you gotta try it out. And that's going to be it today for my tips on writing quickly, aka writing fast. Thank you again for joining me. Again, if you haven't already done so, please hit subscribe. My name is David Webb. I can't wait to see you all again and get some writing done.